IELTS exam right round the corner. Have you not yet started your preparation for IELTS, and are you worried that you will not make the band that you require? Don't worry. In this video, I'm going to give you a really simple plan that is going to help you achieve a bandwidth that is going to be at least one or two bands higher than what you currently are at. Are you ready? Getting the right IELTS band is often a little tricky, because what happens with most students is they do not even know what their target band is. So my first tip to you is set a target. Now, how do I know what my target score or target band is? If you're going for your academic IELTS, then this target is going to be set by the college that you're applying for. The college will have, depending on the course that you're applying for, the college will give a set of parameters that you need to meet. Under that is, they might ask you to get reading, listening, writing and speaking scores that might be in the range of band 7, or in some cases a combination of band 7 and 6, depending again on the course that you're approaching. If you are going for the general category of IELTS, you will have to first check your CSR score and see what is the additional point that you're going to get by getting an IELTS band. This will determine what is your target band score. The second thing you need to do is take an evaluation. If you want to know how long you need to prepare, it is important that you know where you are. Evaluation will give you a quick review of your strengths and weaknesses, and then once you know which sections you are able to do quite easily and the sections that you're lagging behind in, that is, say for example, your section, your strength is your reading and listening, but your weaknesses are your writing and speaking. So once you know that these are the sections that you need to work on, you're going to create a study plan. While creating a study plan, please make sure that you give realistic, achievable, and quantifiable targets. Okay? The study plan should basically take into account number of hours you have in a day, minus 3 or 4 hours, largely because this is time that you might lose out quite subconsciously. Then you're going to break the number of hours that you have for the next 10 days into 4 segments. Okay, you can split it by starting out with the most weakest writing section and then mitigate it with a reading, and then go for your speaking section and then again mitigate it with the listening. So you need to ensure that you are covering all the 4 modules in a single day. Now, the most important element in order to get your preparation right is a mentor or guide. Because unless and until you have a mentor telling you which are the areas that you need to correct and how you can go about correcting yourself, you're going to face a lot of difficulty in the writing and speaking section. For the reading and listening section as well, it is important to understand the strategies involved in getting your answers right. However, if you do not have the time frame to go for an offline class or go to a mentor, you can avail the services of people and have them evaluate your essays at your convenience. Once you've gotten your evaluations right, now you're going to chalk out problem areas and give at least 5 to 6 hours of training in these areas. Finally, step 4, solve sample papers. The more sample papers that you solve, the more confident are you going to be on the day of your examination, because by now you would know what the format of the test is, how the audios come, which are the various pauses, and how you can preemptively answer certain questions. Hope you found this video helpful. If you want to know more about our personal training programs, please visit us at IELTSNinja.com. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel and do click on the bell icon to be updated with more such videos.